Around 1 month ago, I decided to start learning Unreal. This is why I started, and the result in around 1 month. Half a year ago, I graduated with my master's degree in computer engineering and I burnt out from my job. So I just quit my job and start to learn Unreal Engine. From my learning experience, I know the best way to learn a thing is through practice. Therefore, I decided to build a game from scratch on Steam. And I want to finish my game so bad, instead of making a crap game. Not this crap game, okay? I mean a normal one. So, I like to play a lot of games. FPS, card games, RTS, but I decided to make a ball-like only app called Ghosts and Balls. If you want to know why I make this decision, you can check my other video. Let's talk about what have I done in that month. Here we go! First, I need to learn the basics of Unreal Engine. The only thing I need to do is just read all of this. No big deal, right?
1 eternity later.
After that, I understand how Unreal Engine categorizes things into blueprint, materials, static mesh, and so many others. This is the blueprint system. You can do coding by simply connect all the dots. This can make game development easy to get started, but hard to master. You still need to use C++ to create some advanced functions. Oh, by the way, C++ is a programming language that is quite difficult for newcomers. But that's not difficult for me. I'm a real master. Huh? Why does it fail? I love physics system. It makes everything more realistic and more random and allow everyone to be really immersive in the world. Therefore, I put a lot of time into making the player's control and movement smoother and more enjoyable. Make the player easy to roll, jump and bounce with enjoyable feedback. Includes sound effect, visual effect, camera shake. And for skilled players, we can even jump when the ball is bouncing back. It makes the ball jump higher than normal. Although I already put 16 hours per day into the game, the progress is not well, since I make a lot of bad decisions like the insane difficulty of the game, and we will talk about it later. Moreover, there are too many things that need to be learned. Modify 3D models with Blender, change model texture, and create some UI with Photoshop, edit and mix sound effects and BGMs with Audacity, arranging the Steam page and uploading my game using Steamworks. Finally, edit some funny trailers using DaVinci Resolve. And I have zero experience of all of those things before. During that month, I really learned a lot of useful stuff, and the experience was fun. Only if you are not encountering a lot of bugs like me. One of the hardest things is the level design. I have to define the difficulty of my world. I thought it would be easy, so I created the first few levels with my instinct. But after I sent my game to my best friend and he can't even go to the second level with 2 hours, I immediately decided to rearrange the difficulty and the style of the entire world, and also adding a background story. In this world, you are trapped in a ball by a mysterious entity. Definitely not me. You have to go through the whole path to escape from this world. You will go through different scenes: childhood, school, university, work, family, aging, and death. During the time you go through the life, a voice will state that he missed the opportunities to pursue his dreams. And maybe, you will start to think that I don't want to be that guy. I should pursue my dreams, to encouraging everyone to step out of their comfort zone, to grow some balls, to be brave, to seeking our dreams. Next, I studied a lot about how to incentivize players in the game, since I don't want to make a game that only makes people sad and mad because of falling. So I added many Easter eggs and skins to make my world colorful. You can find the skins along the path or in some hidden spots. Also, a lot of interactive objects like music balls, cats, and people are added to the paths. And this is how I'm trying to give everyone a relaxing and challenging game. I also used it around a week to learn how to make a game trailer. There are too many techniques that can incorporate in a 1 minute trailer. I have to learn about the trailer's visual, vibe, music, phases. And to create my trailer, I create different maps and cameras in the game engine. And then replay them thousands of times, just for the perfect 3 seconds clip. After get all the clips, synchronize every frames with the music. That's how you get a game trailer and makes people play your game. optimization. I am revisiting all the blueprints I built to check which function may cost a lot of resources. Find out that I did use a lot of eventex, which means some functions are triggering in every frame, and most of them are not necessary. After changing them to the timer-based event, that reduced the triggering frequency. Also adding a level streaming function, only load objects near you. I did manage to increase the FPS from 30 to 120 with epic graphics quality settings. You can try the demo on Steam now. Learning game development is fun. Getting the reviews and comments from every one of you is funnier. Remember to subscribe this channel and like this video. If you have seen this, you may also be interested in this video.